In this lesson, I will show you how to publish your iOS app on the App Store. Remember our last lesson, we built the iOS app. Now from the backend, you only need two things. The binary file, so you download the IPA file, and also the screenshots that will be needed to describe your app in iTunes Connect. Go to iTunes Connect and log with your developer credentials. Go to the My Apps menu and click the plus to add a new app to your account. This is an iOS app. I will call it Press Count Stores. This app will be in English. And I've chosen the correct app ID for my app. UGS is a number for you, for your reference, to organize your apps outside iTunes Connect. It's a unique identifier. And click Create. A new entry is now available in your iTunes Connect account. Select the primary category for your app and click Save. Now we are going to upload our binary file to iTunes Connect. That's the only step where you need a Mac, because you're going to use Application Loader or Xcode, which are softwares that run on Mac only. Launch Application Loader and sign in with your iTunes Connect credentials. Select your binary file on your computer. Click Next to upload it to iTunes Connect. While the app is uploading, we're going to follow the publication process by describing our app. Go to the Prepare for Submission menu and start by uploading the screenshots of your app. Screenshots are important because this is what people will see before downloading your app. The problem you will face when uploading screenshots to iTunes Connect is that you need to provide screens for every device your app can work on. To ease this process, GoodBarber has built an automatic machine that will create some screenshots for you, but they are made randomly by the script, and so sometimes you may receive some screenshots that are not the best for your app. So I suggest that for the screenshots, you take the time to do them manually on your device, or you can also use your browser or external services that can help you build very beautiful screenshots. In this tutorial, I will do what most people do, but what I don't recommend to do. That is to say, I have uploaded 3 screenshots for the 5.5 inch screens, and I tell iTunes Connect to use for the other sizes those screens. You have the possibility to upload specific screenshots for specific sizes, and this is what I would do if I was about to publish this app on the store for real. You can upload up to 5 screenshots per screen sizes. So do it, take the opportunity to showcase your app the best as you can, and you can even upload a video to showcase your project. I'm going to put now my app description, the associated keywords, the URL with support information for our app, and the URL with marketing information about the app. I'm now going to attach a build to this iTunes declaration. I select the binary I've previously uploaded with Application Loader and I confirm. I upload my app icon. It's a 1024 pixel by 1024. Provide copyright information. Select a rating for your app by answering some questions. To the question, internet access without restrictions, you need to say yes, because your app is going to have access to the internet. Keep the contact of the person that the Apple team can reach if they have questions during the validation process. Select here when you want your app to appear in the stores. It can be just after the validation or on a given date. Save your changes. Go to the Pricing and Availability menu and choose your pricing. For me, this app will be free. Go back to the Prepare for Submission menu and click the Submit for Validation button. If your app has access to external content, click Yes. And click Yes because you should have the right to display this external content inside your app. To the question regarding advertising, click Yes. If you display ads in your app, click all the 3 boxes here If you don't display ads in your app, click only the box in the middle. Accept the rules and click send. Your app is now in the wait for review status. Apple will send you emails to tell you what's the result of this review, if your app is published or if you need to modify things to ask for another review. I hope you enjoyed this video. See you next time, and meanwhile, happy building.